Okay, so the third part is the OOP, object-oriented programming, which is actually the style of Python. So let's see a few things here. So if you still remember our this just now our radius again, we can use that example. So this is the class is called computation. So we can just call the class computation where we pass a parameter 3. Then after that, this is the initial. That means the first program, this function to run, and is called self. So self means that is used for within the class. Then after that, the radius. Okay, so the radius will be from this 3 going to the radius, and then self dot radius equal to 3. Okay, which is the radius here, right? So now if you look at the self here. So all the variable inside here, like self dot radius or self dot something else, you'll be all inside here. And if you just return 3.142 times radius squared, right? Then the parameter will be 3.12 times self dot radius times 2. Okay. So after that, we print the area is a dot area. So parameter will be a dot parameter. So the a will be referring to this computation, and then dot area will be returning this function. Okay, so this is quite a simple creating a class. Okay, the simplest way. Okay, so we're going to do this exercise now, and it's quite simple. Okay, so first of all, we have a class first. Now, so in this class, we just call it computation. Okay. So what we do is we're going to take in only one parameter, the radius. Okay, so just call it R for simplicity. Okay. So define slash slash init. Okay. So remember that for this function, right? Init is always you'll be calling init. And there's always a self. These are the default. Okay, so these are the system key. So you are not going to use this, so radius. Okay, so sorry for that class. Okay, so this is the one that bringing in the parameter radius. Okay, so just to name it easier. Okay, so now in this cell dot radius, so the now the parameter is inside here. So it must be equal to the parameter. Okay. So now what does this init does is that it's quite simple. It just initialize all the class variable. So for this class, okay. So every single function can have their local variable again. Okay. So now we have only two functions here other than this radius. This is to define the variable. So we have area and parameter. Okay. So when we use area and parameter, we are actually using the define area. Okay. Now remember we are taking in self. So that means that anything in the init will be found here. And this is only to return the area. Okay, quite easy, right? So 3.142 times the radius square, which is the cell dot radius, and after that we have square. Okay, square. Okay, so we define another one is called parameter cell dot. So we return 2 times 3.142 times self dot radius, right? So this is the parameter. Okay, so this is the class computation. What we need to do is to define say any say x equal to any variable. So we are calling this class computation. And we are actually putting in a parameter, say for example 5, right? As argument. So you have to calculate the radius and the parameter. So now these five inside there are two function here, two methods, five methods. So two methods here. So now you instantiate the class. Okay. So what you do is that you just print. So simple is that for this one, the first one, they say, for example, you have to put the area is. Okay. So remember, you are taking the object that the a dot sorry x dot area, right? X dot area. Okay. So this is the one that you are printing the area. Okay. Then of course you can do a parameter also, print the parameter is, right? So x dot parameter, right? So basically this is a typical simple class that you, at least the basic, that you have the object oriented programming style. Okay, so let's see the answer. So 5 times 25 times 3, okay, so it's about there. So 2 times 3 times 5, okay, so it's about the correct thing. So this is a typical object oriented programming. So there'll be more detail. So a class can have many functions. So when an object, so when you instantiate a class and that particular thing is an object. So for example, this is object. So this is a class. So X is an object. Okay, so I'm trying to explain this. So X is an object. Now the constructor is the init here. Here is the to construct the object. So this is the, a constructor. Okay, so just a terminology. Okay. So so this example of more detail. And for the property, you want to know whether is there any things, what are the attribute inside, just put this type has attribute. Okay, so you can get that. And methods and function. So again, you have seen all the definition. Those are function as the previous tutorial. But if it's inside the object, is associated with the object, then it's called a method. So like, for example, in this case, this is a method. Okay, this is a method. Although it's a function in a class, but it's a method. Huh? So decorator means that you're trying to do function, also a function in a function, right? So that's a mere decorator. So packages, modules versus class. So packages is a big item. Then inside there are module, and inside a module they could have many classes. So of course private and public as well. So you need to understand that. So public is everyone can access, and private is only inside that particular class that you can see. So you have subclass and polymorphism and inheritance. So inheritance means you take the all the attribute from the previous, like for example, this car inherit from the vehicle, race inherit from the car. And polymorphism means that you are able to do different action here. Okay, so this is the inheritance. Okay, so now, so all these are considered subclass. Huh? So polymorphism will be, you are able to do the action. Okay. So there are some other things that in Python that I'm going to start on the other slides, on the other recording. Huh? Okay.